This is gonna change our lives.
Big Flash!
We're gonna have Spider-Man swing in, say you guys are tight, and then I get a...
Hey, welcome back to Landscape Alert, where this week we are going to be recreating the landscape plan for Liz Toomes' home from Spider-Man Homecoming, which we also see Tom Holland as Peter Parker, Michael Keaton as Adrian Toomes, or the Vulture, and also Robert Downey Jr., among many others. Now that we have that out of the way, let's get to the actual design. Now, this home is, on the movie, set in the area of New York, but in reality is in Atlanta, Georgia, which we're gonna have some similar stuff growing in both areas. Now that we kind of have a little bit of the background to this, let's get to the design in itself. One thing I should point out is that this house in itself is very, very nice. Just the architecture to it is really beautiful. It's a very well executed home, if you will. And at the same time, they are not really trying to overdo the landscape, so the house actually stands out. In fact, from the moment you see it, even in the movie, most of it you're going to see it from the inside, which again, plays really well with the strength of it being really well designed. But there is the outside as well, so let's talk a little bit about that. Now, for the most part, we are going to see there's a good amount of sod grass at the entrance of the house. There is a long sidewalk with a little bit of space at the very beginning of grass, about a few inches, I would say somewhere between 6 and 8 inches, not very much more than that. And the pathway is about 5 or so feet wide, and it stretches from pretty much the entrance of the house all the way to the main axis of the house, which is roughly about 80 or so feet from the curve of the house. From there on out, we have on both sides of this pathway to the house grass, and then we also have an island in the middle of this sod. Now, in this sod area, or in this island in the sod area, we have a mixture of perennials and grasses. In fact, we have some pampas grasses. Now, this area is a little bit elevated, but not too much in itself. In fact, it's a bit of a berm situation, but only by about a few inches, enough to where it's above where you would see the grass, but not too much. So you have a mixture of some pampas and also some perennials down below. As you kind of get close to the house, you will have something similar. In this area, you'll have some mulch, wood mulch specifically, and then you have some ornamental grasses and a few other shrubs. Now, on the opposite side, you will have a tree, which to me seems to be like a smaller deciduous tree, maybe something like a Japanese maple, just to kind of give it that color. One thing to mention about this is that in the movie, we don't really see one, because it's at night, so it doesn't really allow us to see anything. But the pictures that we can get, unfortunately, they're in the time of year where some of them have lost their leaves. Obviously not all of them, but some of them have, even though in this area there is a lot of moisture even in the winter time. But that being said, we can, you know, put whatever we want in this case, because we are recreating this design. So for the purposes of this, let's add, say, a maple. We'll talk a little bit more in the details to what else we have there. And then next to the house, we have a few shrubs. I would probably say something like a boxwood right next to it. In the back area, or the opposite side of the house, that's where you have the entrance to the garage or the driveway. In this area, we have some trees, some grass, some mulch, and we also have a few other shrubs, something like Japanese maple. We can sort of see one like those. Again, it's a little hard to tell, but at least the pictures for the back, we have more than the front, so it seems to be something like that. Even I think that we also have something like a linden for a tree on one side, on one corner, some smaller ornamental grasses that can be potentially, depending on your taste, and if you were to want to copy these, it could be something like a grama grass, kind of in the lower area, and also seems to have some bamboos or something similar to that. We also have next to the house a few different perennials and a few different shrubs. It seems to be something like a juniper, like a lower juniper, and also some perennials right there. And then on one side we see something like cedars, so some larger evergreens. So let's talk a little bit about some measurements of this front area. So we did talk about earlier about how we had the entrance be about 80 or so feet, but let's get into more details over here. So the width of the house is at least not the house itself, but the lot itself is of 60 feet, and that's by the length of the house to be of about 170 or so feet. Now, because it is not a rectangle, it's on one side 170 ish and then the opposite side way closer to the 220, give or take. So that is what we're looking at as far as the property in itself. Now, the grass area from where we have the pathway to the entrance of the house to the property line, it's about 45 or so feet. It's a little bit under the 45, it's about 40. And then there's a little bit of space that they seem to be sharing. It seems to be more on the other side of the property, but there is this mulch area where you also have some shrubs that kind of are dividing on actually both sides. In this case, we have this space, and then if we measure from the curve to the back, where we would have the end of where we have the house and where the grass would stop, is about roughly around 75 or so feet. The island that we talked about earlier across would be somewhere in the 35 feet or so, as far as how long it is, and as far as how wide this would be is about 18 or so, with the earlier information that it does have some mulch and some pampas grasses here. Now on the other side, we also have next to it in the front as well, we'll have another area of also mulch and also some other grasses. Now this grass seems to be a little bit taller, so for this, let's say that we have some Carl Fosters, because those are really nice. And if we have some of those here, how about we also have some on the opposite side, where we also have a little bit of that mulch again and some more grasses to make this house look even nicer, even though this house looks fantastic, I will say. As I mentioned earlier, we have a tree there, and we have a lot of trees that are going there. Now, in this area, like many others, you have a good selection for different kinds of trees, and we can probably say a few names of some maples if we were to want to do that. As is, there are already a few maples that I would probably put in this design if I was working with this, especially the Japanese, something like a Blotwood Japanese, an Emperor, or a Hefner's Red. Potentially for elms, I would do something like a Princeton, and maybe for some oaks, something like a Burr or Nut All, Scarlet, or a Red Oak. Those would also look quite fantastic, and those will grow quite large, minimum, or I would say above 40 feet, between 40 and 60, and some can definitely be bigger. Now, talking a bit of shrubs that we have in that sort of entrance of the house, we can have something like roses if you were into roses. Now, if you were to want to copy this, you can definitely have many things, but I think roses will look quite nice, maybe like a popcorn, pink, peach, red, the list goes on and on. You can also have some different perennials. Now, as far as shrubs that we can have here, we can have something like a clayera, a variegated boxwood, Acacia pieris, Lauren Pentalume jazz hands, and of course you can do way more, but this seems to be overall the design, at least what I'm doing over here, trying to get as much information but as well give you guys some options in case you guys don't have all of this ones. You know, I am putting some pictures up, that way you guys can sort of tell what they look like in case you are wanting to use some of those in your designs for your house. What do you guys think about this though? Is this something that you guys would use for your own landscape. And if you saw the movie, what do you guys think about the movie? Let me know in the comments and let me know what shrubs you noticed here that maybe I did not catch. If you want to put them in the comments, I would definitely appreciate that. And of course, I would appreciate if you guys do all that YouTube stuff that generally YouTubers ask you to do, which is subscribe, like, and obviously tell your friends about us, that sort of stuff. Anyways, guys, I will see you guys in the next video, but don't forget our motto, which is dream, design, create. Have a good one. Bye.